I see no match unless they're going.
Yeah.
They're going 2.5 yards in a race, going Tyreek. I get Tyreek a chance. After 3 yards, you gotta have, and I'm just saying this, you gotta have dry length and stride. There's only much dry length, Tyreek.
Yeah.
Yeah, he would have a better chance at a shorter race. Going to get a guy. This is trap.
He's bigger too, man.
Yeah, he's taller. He's longer.
Yeah,
he's
reach.
Kyrie can't even beat this shape. I love that. I would see love see that more of a fair rate football. Football.
Yeah.
The football gets a 100 meter trap.
Everybody seen DK hunt that dude down to. That interception, you've seen that? Yeah.
Yeah, we saw him in traffic at the red light. I got a picture of him in Arizona. DK saw him in the, some guy, when he saw him in the rearview mirror, he said, watch. Guess who didn't get to the rear. I'm like, what? Pulled up. He said, this is the guy I chased down. And the guy was like this. And you know, DK just looking at him like this. So he's like, he looked over like, oh man. He was like, yeah, what's up, man? So I took a picture of him coming at the light. So it was pretty cool. Cause DK was like, you don't miss nothing. Cause you know me, I take a lot of pictures and film. I don't miss nothing.
Yeah.
On my phone at all. Hold up just a second.
I stay on him. I'm like, dude, this is ugly. That's ragged. That's pretty. That's bad. That's horrible. This is not going to
be good.
I need your rep, I need your attention, I need you. That's why most of our videos are out of the park. And it's out of the city. I don't need all this rep. I don't need my camera. Like me and you out here now. It's how we get better. Our rep. So. We're going to start with just 2-point standing start. Just give me about 3 good strides of these two wall back. Working on that release. Working on just the first 3 steps always tells me and tell you how you set yourself up.
Sometimes I feel like this arm that's coming, what was it? It would be the arm that's coming. The first arm to come up and then back is a little too long. I feel like.
You don't want to short it.
Yeah.
That's what I was working on. I'm on my own yesterday, just being patient in my push. Because you want to get back on the track. Surface so quick that you make you actually you come here and you stand yourself up. I'm trying to get back, then you'll go from here to, and you shorten it.
Yeah.
You wanna go long to get out. You wanna practice long. So then you get time to come shorter. So it's shorter than it's short already, but it's shorter. Now this next one, I want you to purposely, we want to make sure we warmed up also. I want you to purposely hold your knee position. I want you to purposely hold the knee position. As long as you can with your toe down, come out. You have so much power. If you hold the position as long as you can, with your heel tucked in your hamstring. Don't let it get out here and then you stand up. So when you come out in power, lunge out, but just do
I just want you to right now to do one step like that.
You want me to hold it, like, place up on this one, so it would be...
Yeah, I want you to...
Before I, as long as I can, before I hit the ground again, or...
Yeah, but I still want you, when you come up, I want you to tuck like this and push it back down. So right now, just do one step. Just drive out, hold it, don't feel fun. So if I was here, I'd have to take my step. Drive up, push down. You gotta push back.
Yeah, I need to push back.
Yeah,
I went back down all right.
Yeah, you gotta push down. You gotta drive up, and then push back underneath it to push yourself forward. Right there.
That's a little
too late.
Yeah,
that's good. That's what I'm looking for.
Yeah, that's the picture you're talking about.
Yeah, it's gonna feel hard because right now when you're. You know, you're not running bad. We teach you how to transition to that to 40.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. That to 60, whatever, that to 100. That's all we're doing. Teaching your body to get. We're teaching your body to fire your hips to get out there to you. Leg and quickness. That's all.
I just need to wait a second longer.
Yeah, it's
a little bit longer on that.
Yeah, it's just one of those drills you can put in your bag that you can use. It's what track and field guys use to warm up. Jamaica's a very, very known for pounds to warm up with because they want to be able to get up. They want to use the M press.
Uh-huh.
So they work on drills to make them get up first. Because they know when they get ready to run, it's So they want to be up. They want to make sure they hear it back down first. These drills, good. Now you're there. Now let's go.
I need to tuck. I think I'm still flexing that a little bit.
Yeah.
I need to tuck it.
The idea is not to get here. Again, I have to go through these drills. I might wake up and go and drive to a track, literally. I'll go to the pasture and like, okay, why am I coming here and end up with my ankle under my knee? That's not what I want. I can't. All I can do is push up from here. I want to be able to push you this way.
Yeah.
So what am I? You know, you have to have crazy reps. So now let's go. Let's go 1-2. It's gonna feel like a kangaroo or tigger or Winnie the Pooh. It's gonna be. All it is bounds.
Yeah.
That's all it is. That's all it is. Teaching. Bound. When you actually run to get the root point, you just gonna go knee drive, knee drive. There you go. This way you're floating, but you're attacking at the same time. You're going M, press, A, B, C, I need, not just that thing, the M out of the way. Bound. There you go. Good. That was good. That was a rip.
I slowed it down a little bit. Felt better.
See, that's allowing, and that, I can see, hip firing.
Yeah.
I can see you using your hips. If your hips doesn't fire, your knee. And I'm gonna go ahead and admit, I was bad at it too until I learned the research. I've been blessed. I ain't gonna lie. I've been blessed and tricky. Fast guys in the world. I don't know why he blessed me with that, but I'm thankful for it. So I learned a lot that I was even doing wrong. And even when I used to tell my athletes, pick your knees up. High knees, get high knees. And the first thing, you know, I used to watch film, and they're doing high knees, and get your knees up, and they go.
Yeah.
Go here, I'm like, you got your knees up. But why they not going nowhere? It's because I didn't realize, even when I went to a biotech training trip, and I had a 7-metal, ran the fastest time in the 60 in the world. When Coach Ralph had them in the block. We're at a facility you can imagine the facility, I'm gonna go deer hunting stage. If you can go to a field, you got a deer hunter and say, the biggest buck in the world is on that field. You go down and have any of them. That's gonna be a deer hunter's dream. So imagine a trap with me as a trainer having all the Olympians, gold medalists, silver medalists, bronze medalists, world champions, all on one track where I'm at. You know how I was.
Yeah.
Like, oh my goodness, I didn't get that information. So what I learned from Ralph, when that trail got in the block, he said, come, he ain't getting the things yet. I said, he's getting them up. He said, yeah, but he's fighting because he's not firing his foot from the block. If you just tell him to lift his knee, then he's gonna misfire his hips. But if you tell him to fire his hips, then it's gonna make his knee lift automatically. So if I worry about you, if you worry about this firing, this will make the knee lift. But if these don't fire, yeah, you can lift your knee, but you're gonna drop it. You're gonna misfire your hip. Now when you hear me say instead of high knees, that's like hip fire. After years, I can recreate the habit. But these drills allow you to fire your hip like I just saw. That was perfect because I saw your hip. I saw this one. Okay. It caused you to lift. This was getting loose. So when that got loose, you got more stride extension. And it was just so it was pretty. Say it all like that just to let you know.
Yeah.
I train y'all to train. Yeah, I just train y'all to train, so that way you'll know, even if you train yourself, or you train somebody else later on in life, you know, okay, this is what I learned. But yeah, that was good.
Same thing?
Yeah, same thing. So, repeat them good reps. Yeah. Yeah. We're gonna go four times. Yeah, that's looking a lot better. A lot better. I'm gonna get here so we can hit those. Make sure we're hitting those angles correctly. This is always really good for you to do.
That's not translating to speed. Yeah, it's just
how it feels for a game or for a living.
Right.
So, yeah, I'm doing this and this, and I'm not doing this.
Right.
Okay, I don't know what that has to do with
what you mean.
Yeah.
Maybe it helps you mentally, it's not helping you physically.
Help you feel good.
Oh yeah. Make it look easy now.
Yeah. This is gonna be the. I kind of felt after that second one, I wanted to get back down really quick. At that third, it didn't feel as like. I guess. I felt like I kind of rushed.
Well, because you are. Once you get this down, you are going to be attacked.
Yeah, I guess you're going to be moving quickly. Yeah, that makes sense.
You're going to be moving quickly, but it's going to feel like, the naked eye is going to feel like you're not bounding in between, which you really are.
Yeah.
So now you can go on from this up to this. For example, now you're going from your first step to here to being there. That makes a difference down there. Uh-huh. That much. If you are bounding more by firing your hips, you want more, then we're going to go. Go do it at 100. All right, good. Now, we're going to do the same thing at 100%.
But not, I don't want you thinking about bounding, but I want you to do, just do what you were doing when you started.
And it should come in, it should come into play. It should come into play.
Whether it feels like it or not. Sometimes I go feel like it.
Yeah.
Sometimes I feel like, man, I'm not going nowhere. But when you go back and look at it, you're like, same forward, like going three steps before. Get out four steps. Remember, five, four times. Dude, that's such a big difference.
Yeah, that first step is so much more powerful. I would feel like I'm stretched instead of like right there.
You're doing just enough to your release and your press. That's what that was. Like when you started out, it was press.
Yeah.
Sometimes you can't get on the athlete. Like it's 7 o'clock in the morning on Sunday, and it's cold. And now we're on double drill. That's why we do drill first.
Yeah. Gotta get my head straight. I'm so tired. I used to be so flexible, or I guess mobile. But like, man. Basically, ever since we started lifting a lot, I should have been consistent with the routine, but I just kind of, I didn't purposely push it away. It just kind of fell off, and I regret that so much.
Back more to
get. Yeah. Because now it's like, when you're doing it, you realize like, dang, if I could get my hip like up here, I could really bring that back down.
I knew from then on, I was like, okay. Because I hadn't trained him in a while, in football. So I'd get him a track note. Like, okay, new drills, get his boots.
Yeah,
okay, no problem. But get his nose. I think that's something good for him. Yeah. Good. Now we're going to go into, now time to go into.
Going to 3 point and use that same, well, let's go here. Use that same fire technique. That's what, like I said, that's what I was working on.
Yesterday, we realized that I don't have a lot of tips. Instead of getting away from it, I'm different. I don't. So busy. I'm actually busy. That's an excuse. I'm making excuses. So from there, you definitely have to fire.
Yeah.
That means that you're raising that.
I was trying to do it.
I could put a tray on it. In the cafeteria and go get some. Go get my juice and come back. Thank you. Appreciate that, Derek. Oh, the tray book. It wasn't going to slide off nowhere. That tray was going to beat it on that flat surface. Butt's got to go up. Head is down. If the head goes down, butt comes up. Head is up, look at that. That's better. You gotta be able to use your big toe.
Big toe.
get on that big toe. Front and back, yeah. Just like that. You go a little bit more. Right here. Yeah. Right there. I said it takes a lot of rep. Because you just not learning stance.
Yeah.
So, and the stronger you get, the more your stance is going to change. The stronger you get, the looser you get, depending on the time of the year, the spring, summer. You know, everybody likes to get on that line and cheat it. You know, I don't want to run 41 yards. You're not. You're stripping your body these days. You drive, baby. Baby, not pop charts. Like, because then you can't fuck. That's not true. Come up. That's why I was working on yesterday, so I had to set my camera's working on chest. So I want to, again, look at the logo. I want to hide the logo. I want to see my head way in front of my hips. I want to be almost like a folding chair. So you got to use your core. Coming out. So in other words, your heel recovery starting out can't be high.
Yeah.
The shin shouldn't go up here where it's facing me down there if I'm kind of. The shin has to stay in front shin. Which is cool. Low as you can is come out. Come out, keep it low. Keep it up there. Squeeze those core. There you go. Good. Now you be patient with your head.
Yeah. I landed. This came back. It was a heel. I get there.
Yeah, and you're not going to get, right now, you're not going to get that four. You want to make sure you get those. Make sure we know what we're looking for, so we're doing it on your own. You know what's good rep, what's bad rep. And then that way you just discard all the bad reps and just watch the good reps. You know, just watch the bad reps. I see somebody misinformation. And some of it could be mine. I don't know. They might look at my information. You don't know what you're doing. You know better, tell me. That was a good rep. Other than you wasn't patient with the
heels.
Yeah. Yeah. Keep your eyes a few steps in front of you. There you go. Good. Being patient with your head. Some have asked me, but coach feel like I'm falling and I'm jamming myself into the
chest. That's what I felt like there.
I'd rather for you to be that way than be popping up like a pop tart. If you can fix that. How do you fix that? Is you squeeze yourself up in a ball. Pull. That way you won't be just down there. So I gotta use my hip flexors and core when I come out. I gotta pull them in my chest. Core. That's where the core come in. And you won't feel like you fight gravity. But now you're pulling, remember, M press. So press.
Yeah.
Press is what has you falling. But I'd rather for you to be falling than popping up like a poke. So now all you gotta do is do a little bit bounding in there with that. And that'll take care of that every single time. Every single time. Every single time. Hips. Just think about all I want to think about hip flexors and lower core. Hip flexors and lower core. Use it every time you step. Make them work for you. Right there, right there. Good. Good.
See how hold everything down. By the time you slow down, you probably grab the point.
Yeah.
But you took care of the team. You took care of 0 points. Might get out right. The rest of it might not be successful. It might not be successful. It might not be just want to fuck somebody else.
Yeah, I feel like I was tripping. I really crunched and tried to pull these, and I didn't trip over myself.
That's why here, again, I had to learn it myself. And I said, again, I can't talk about how blessed I am to train some of the best in the world. Mm-hmm. And watch trail, train the trail. Who has the top, did the research of the top 10 quickest starts in track and field history. We were number 8 in track and field history. I'm from that position. So, learning a lot, watching him, training him, taught me a lot that I can give to y'all. So, that's why he made sure his hips were stretch. His hip flexors were good, and his core, his lower core, was ready. He fired. All that's got to fire. If I can fire all that, my position. I let my head lead the way like a bullet. You know, I always call it like a, I call it nookwood. Y'all hit the ball head. All I see is his knees going right up under his nose, like this. I've never seen his eyes. By the time he got here, I've seen his nose start to raise. I've never seen his eye color or nothing. So I tell guys, I joke with guys, when I get to the 10 or 20, I said, I should be able to tell what shampoo you use because I'm looking at the top of your head the whole time.
Yeah.
Like, you want your head back? I see it when you come to the 10. Oh, you use a head and shoulders. Oh, okay. I like that. Head's really shining up there. Okay. I should be able to tell that.
Yeah.
When you come to that. That right there was a perfect example. You engage your hip flexors. Core and your hips, oh, it's a beautiful thing. And you catch it with your head, lead with your head. That's a hot time, every time. That's nice here. That's nice. Oh yeah. That's what I wanted to do today. Mostly was getting your 10 in, and we're gonna work a little bit more from that. But I want to make sure I get a front view. Of that 10.
Bigger sweep, not quick, big. Good.
Yeah, when you try to purposely, put that toe right on the other side of that back foot. When you come out, I want you in front of that. back leg is low. Your front angle of your front leg and your back leg is the same angle. What should be up for. You're going back, you're going cafeteria tray again.
Cafeteria. If I ever do it, you just need to say cafeteria.
You've been cafeteria thinking about me. Coach, say I look like this tray. Good, good. Good. Now you jam down a little bit.
You're like, you lost a little bit of patience. You can tell.
I got sideways, yeah.
You got a little bit impatient on your push, on your knee drive. Work on the first
and track and field. Sometimes we start and go, what happened? Second step, third step, first step.
Yeah.
So they know what. Once they get three steps and they're out, it's over with. The rest of it's over with. So I might look like a kid on the playground running. My first three steps is gonna stay up. So you bound, you sweep, sweep, sweep. What happens to you, if you bring your arms up, just try to run, it's gonna affect that. All that's gonna be thrown off. So when I come out, I got to be like, not like a skier, but like, we call it sweeping. Hands low, and open. So I'm like this. And as I come up, I start bringing my hands in, arms in, and get a little tighter. When I come out, it's like I'm skiing, pushing myself out. My arms in here, and I can't get out. Yeah. Then I'm like, So I got to. We call it a sweeping. Arms low, powerful, away from my body. Project us this way. Projection. Project down the track. Good. Getting out a whole lot better though. Whole lot better.
I rushed out.
Yeah. And I told you that's gonna happen.
I told myself I'm not gonna rush
it. We need to do one in slow motion. Or not 100%.
Do like a half speed.
Yeah, that's what we need to do.
Because I don't think we did. I think we did them out of the three. We did them out of the two.
I forgot what he was doing out of the two reps, out of the two steps.
That is. It's kind of dead. I gotta really push it.
So, alright, I'm gonna make you go 100% again.
Alright.
This is what I want you doing. You're doing it, but you're not focused on squeeze. Focus on getting down the track. I need you to, because when you come out, I just need you to ball up. I need you to use your core. If I was here, you need to be just trying to kick me all the way down here. I need to see your knee. Patient as you can before you put it down. I want to see how long can you hold your knee drive before you put it down and still have your heel tucked in there. How long can you hold it? Full speed. That's what I'm looking for. Even if the other two steps not good, I want to see how long you can hold that knee drive and squeeze from your chest to your knee, knee to your chest. How long can you hold that? Tuck that in. You got enough power to do that. What I'm saying. How long can you knee somebody down the trail? Just like that. Just like that, you got out. You notice that?
That was good. Good patience.
Clear, just to like focus on this stuff instead of it being like in the groove. Like, there's, it'll be a time and a place, you know, or I guess not a place, but always time for like different things. But I like this.
That's why I like to know when just Callie comes by herself, the other girl. I love her being here. I need our one-on-one for a Ricky. I need that one. Your angle. Killing it now. Good. A lot better.
You just warming up on me.
Start quick. You can't start quick if you're trying to get long.
Yeah. You can't go long trying to get quick. Learn to fire your hips from here and just keep them firing for 19 to 20, yeah. 21 strides. That's all you're doing. 19 to 21 strides. Shooting through with 40, 22, 23 at the most. But if your hips are loose and they're firing from the gate, you just keep firing. The first three steps, so hey, you can't ask no more than that.
Yeah.
Get one more good one in, and
we'll call it a morning. Church.
I got so much stuff to do. Well,
one, two, three, she's like, up, 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 boom, boom, boom.
Stand. Good. Good.
I know it. Love it, I love it.